everyone, Vera Flidia here, and welcome back to the second part of the Flea Market Haul episode 57, if I am correct. So this is the second part of that Flea Market Haul video. I talked a little bit more about why I have to, you know, make this video two parts long, and what happened to the flea market and whatnot on the first part of this video. So you can go ahead and check it out if you haven't seen it yet. It's there on my channel. It's the video actually before this one, so you will be able easily to find it. I won't be able to put one of those little clickable button thingies up there because I do have to, you know, turn off the comments on this video because of the YouTube policy and whatnot. And when you turn that thing off, you actually have to turn that thing off too, so it auto turns that off. And yeah, that's why I won't be able to put that little button thing over there, so sorry about that, guys. But if you are interested in the first part, you will be able to easily find it on my channel. So in the second part, I'm going to show you more stuff that I found on the flea market and that I have from that online order as well. So I'm just going to start off with some random bits and pieces. Some of them are like little statues or statuettes, and the other ones are just some random stuff. So first off, I have here a doll item, a doll, kind of like a playset, but it's not really a playset. It's a doll vehicle, let's call it that, because it is a scooter. And as you can see, this is a Monster High scooter. To be exact, it's Gulia's scooter. And I was super surprised to find that this in such a great condition on the flea market. The tires are still like pretty much intact. And the whole thing is, it's nothing's missing from it except with the except that little plastic part that makes the scooter stand and not fall down. So that's the only thing that's missing from here. The little coffin thing here in the back still has the lid, and the mirrors are still here, the little decorations, and everything is just really in really really nice condition. It was in for a great price to, like, it was around $2. So yeah, that's a great price for such a nicely looking piece. Not sure what I'm going to do with it because I wasn't like really collecting the Monster High furniture and items and all of those things, but I just couldn't pass this one because it was such a great deal. I'm just probably going to, you know, pack it away and keep it for maybe use it for photos or something like that. I don't know. Now the next one is a figure slash doll. It's, I think her name is Mrs. Frog or Mrs. Toad. I think it's Mrs. Toad. And she's from the Thumbelina movie, which I never in my life saw that movie, so I don't know. I mean, I know the story of Thumbelina, but I haven't seen that movie that she is from. And she's in really great condition. Her hair is still pretty beautiful. I actually put this feather up here to make her look more like accurate to the how she originally looked, because that was missing. She is like a steel figure, you can't really move any parts on her, but I thought that she was really cute, and I grabbed her. And as I found out online, she is like kind of like a pretty rare toy. All of the stuff from that movie is pretty rare, so yeah, I'm happy to have her. Not sure where I'm going to put her or where I'm going to display her, because she doesn't really fit in anywhere, but I don't know, I just really liked it. And speaking of doll like accessories, I have here a Barbie dog, and it's one of those pooping dogs actually. And it's, I'm pretty sure it's still working, but it's missing the little poops or little bites or whatever you're feeding him. And as you can see, if you pull down the tail, his head moves, and if you pull or push this ear, or is it this one? Oh, it's this one. he will open his mouth. So yeah, it's in pretty good condition. I actually bought this for one of my dolls as a dog. So yeah, I was happy to find one of these flocked ones because I'm not a big fan of the just simple plastic pieces. I wish he was a little bit more articulated than just a steel figure, but it's better than nothing. I have one of these little rams over here, or sheep. Well, it's a ram because it's a boy, and I'm not sure what this is. I'm pretty sure it's like a kind of like a decoration, and I only bought this because I am going to use it for a project that I'm working on, or I'm going to start working on soon, so it will go great with that project. And now for statues, I found one of these small like Egyptian statues. This is Horus, if I am correct. The paint job is could be better, so I might actually like repaint it. But you know, I love Egyptian mythology, and I have a bunch of the god statues over there on one of my shelves, so I'm going to display this one over there. And again, speaking of god statues, I have found this, and I was really like stunned by it when I found it. This interesting demon dragon looking thing. It's like a hollow wood, so I was pretty sure that this is a handmade or hand carved item, and I don't know, I think it's just so cool looking. And later I found out with some help that it's from the Bali Islands, and yeah, it's just such a weird find over here, and it's such a interesting find as well, and I really really like it. I think it looks really cool, and really I don't know, I just might use the idea of this. At first I thought actually that it was the Garuda bird from there, but it looks different, so it does not have a beak, so I'm pretty sure it's not the Garuda, it's some kind of other type of demon from their culture. But I might actually use the idea for a Monster High OC character in the future. I might customize a doll similar to this, because I really, really love the idea and I really love how it looks. And the last but not least, the last statue, is this super cute vampire bat mouse thing, because it's actually like a vampire. And it has like bat wings, but it's also like a mouse too, so a little bit of both, I guess. And it's pretty interesting, he has huge shoes. I do know this brand, I have saw a lot of stuff from this brand, I'm not sure what's it called, but I just thought that it's super cute. The paint has chipped off at some places, so I have to fix it as best as I can, but I think it still looks really cute. And I really like it. So yeah, those are all the random bits and pieces. Now let's move on to some action figures. And one of the action figures that I picked up from my collector friend, and I'm really really happy to have this one because it's such a rare find, it's one of the Mask action figures, and this one is the Cyborg Mask. As you can see, he's half like robot and half the original, and it looks just so amazing. He has seen a little bit better days because the paint is chipped here and there, but it's still really really awesome looking, and it's such a great addition to my really small The Mask collection, because as I said before, they are really rare over here, and yeah, so I'm just really happy to add this to my collection. Now all the other action figures and stuff that I'm going to show you guys are all Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, because I have a huge huge lot of them, a huge haul, and I just don't know where to start. I actually have like a full box over here next to me, so Yeah, let's just start somewhere. And the first one is actually a plushie, and this one is from the 2012 series, from the smaller sized plushies, because there are bigger sized ones, and I have from the bigger sizes I have Raphael. Now from the smaller sizes, this is my first one, and this is Michelangelo, as you can see, and he is super cute. I really, really love him. I think he is so adorable with that cheeky face and smile that he has on, and the plushie is just in such a great condition, and yeah, so it's super adorable. Now the other ones are all, of course, action figures, and some I actually have some vehicles as well, so I'm not sure. I guess I'm going to start off with the vehicles because they are the larger pieces. So I have here this motorcycle, I guess, or it's something similar to that. This one is from the Paleo Patrol line, and boy, my Paleo Patrol line, if only I could find like two more of the turtles, Mikey and Donny, I would have more, almost all of the line. With the exception of the actual dinosaurs, but I have a lot of the stuff, figures and vehicles and the whatnot from the Paleo Patrol series. So I don't know, I have a luck finding those. Now it's in really good condition. Some of the paint has chipped off over here down below, but it's nothing too serious. This hook thing is not working as it should. You have to pull it out, and with the this skull thing, you have to like retract it. That button is not working properly, so I'm not going to pull this out and retract it, because it's just a really annoying thing. And the missile from here, from the front, is missing, but otherwise it's in pretty good condition, so I'm happy to have it. And the other vehicle is also from the Paleo Patrol series, and this is the Dino Capture vehicle, if I am correct, or Dino Capture bike or car, or I'm not sure what's the original name. The only thing is missing is this. It was supposed to have this red cage-like thing here in the front that you were supposed to fire out and capture the dinosaur, but yeah, otherwise it's in great condition and has all of the other stuff, of course missing the weapons, but you know, that's to be expected. But yeah, I wish it still had the dino cage in the front, and that way it would be like complete. So those are the two vehicles. I actually have a playset here too. I just need to, like, because it's on the at the bottom of the box, so I have to free it. So I'm going to start off with some vintage TMNT figurines. Let me just grab them if I can. I have 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. So I have 6 vintage TMNT figurines over here. Let's start off with the turtle. So this is Raphael from the storage shell line. The only thing that's missing is the shell, unfortunately. I was debating if I should get this figure or not, but I actually have some knockoff turtles, and I can easily replace the missing shell. It's still on the original, but it's still something, so I'm still happy with it. I'm going to put these over here. Next up we have Master Splinter from one of the movies. So this is the movie Splinter. He still has his robe, which has seen a little better days, but it still looks pretty decent. And this is the flocked Master Splinter, so he is pretty unique in my opinion. And we have here the Fugitoid, or Professor Honeycutt, not sure if that was his name in the, you know, the, these original series, but that was his name in the 2003 line, so that's from where I remember him. But he looks really cool, and the figure itself is in great condition. I have here Metalhead. Now, he would be in great condition if only one of his arms weren't missing. So, not sure if I will be able to replace that. Or maybe someday find another Metalhead who has the arm. We'll see, but I'm still happy to have him in my collection. And we have two villains. One of them is the Rat King, and he is in great condition. The only thing is missing that it's one of the rats is actually like broke off from here, from his shoulder, which is unfortunate, but otherwise he is in great condition. And the other villain is Pizza Face, and I think he is super such a like ugly but super interesting character, you know, with one pizza peg leg. So yeah, I'm really happy to have this one. So those are the vintage figures. Now I have here one of the figures from the 2007 movie line. This one is Michelangelo with the, and he was supposed to have more stuff on him. Not sure what the line is called, but as you can see, it looks really like futuristic and robotic. But yeah, those parts are missing on him. So, but still, the figure itself has seen also better days. Like his bandana is just like kind of looks like melted. So something must have happened with the figure somewhere. I don't know. Some of that stuff actually stuck onto his face. So I have to get that off. I don't know how, because otherwise I have cleaned the figure, so maybe the stuff is still like rubbing off, I don't know. I have here from the 2006 series, the Fast Forward one, a mini Raphael, and I do know these came in like blind bags originally. He is missing his stand, but still, I think he's pretty cool. Moving on, I have here from the Michael Bay version movie, a Michelangelo. So now I think I'm only missing Raphael from the Michael Bay version to have all four turtles. Which, by the way, if you know me, you know that the Michael Bay movies, it's not one of my favorites. I really hate the designs of the turtles in it, but you know, still, they go into my collection. And I have more of the from the 2003 series, and these are like really awesome. You will be able to see these on the pictures a little bit better. These are like keychains, but they are also like little toys as well, and you can play around with them. They are like training turtles, and each of them come with these little training dummies on the bottom, and you have to pull this little lever thingy out and in, like push it and pull it, and the turtles will move. Not all of them are working. Okay, Donatello is working a little bit better. As you can see, you can twist it and turn it, and he will just, you know, fight with that training dummy, which is a pretty cool idea if you ask me. I have Donnie, Mikey and Raph from this series, so I'm only missing Leo. But I have, before I got this, I have never ever seen these, so I think this is like something, a cool, nice little idea, and the figures on those are actually like really nicely painted as well. Moving on, I have some stuff from the 2012 series over here. This one is one of the like re-releases or recolored versions of Leonardo, where he has his eyes painted. He has seen better days because the bandana has broken off and he's missing the katana holder from his back, but otherwise it's a really weird figure in my opinion. Like, he has a real weird expression on his face. And the other ones are like larger stuff, larger figures. I have this Raff over here, which is one of those like, they remind me of those Flutterby fairy type of toys when you have to just launch it and he will just come flying down like twirling. The launcher is missing, so otherwise I would have never like bought this by itself, but he was in a bundle that I bought online, so I'm keeping it. But otherwise I would have probably never bought it because it's just not something for me, and I don't think it's that that like fun. It's just you know. The other ones, the larger figures, are all like interactive, so they do something or used to do something. We have this series over here, and these, both of these are from the same series, and actually from this series there's one more Raphael, which I actually have in my cabinets over back there. The Raphael is not working and these aren't working as well, so I guess there was something wrong with this line, or I don't know, they just broke so easily. These are one of those like wind-up toys, and yeah, none of them is working. Mikey was supposed to, you know, spin this stick around because it doesn't look like a nunchuck for me, or to me, and I don't know what Leo was supposed to. I think he was supposed to like make cartwheels, or what's that called in English, I'm not sure. None of them is working, so I don't know. And we have one of these also interactive Mikeys, and as you already heard, he is working, and he is super annoying as well, because if you just move him slightly, he will, or he just bumps into something and immediately starts to scream. He's one of those like training turtles, so you have to like push him and he makes noises, and sometimes he actually like randomly makes noises, and there is no off button on this thing, so I would suggest if you have this, just take out the batteries. I will do that as well, because it's just annoying that he just randomly screams like in the middle of the night or something. So yeah, that's, as you can hear, it's kind of like, I don't know, the toy seems to be a little bit broken or something, that he screams all the time. So I'm just going to place him over there. And another one of the interactive pieces is this Raphael, which is in kind of like in training or something like that, and you are supposed to like push him down in this position, and if you let him go, he would just, you know, make a flip and jump. Nothing too amazing about that, but it's still a fun little toy. He is missing, of course, his weapons, but yeah, it's still a pretty cool piece, and at least this one is not broken or anything. I have here three Pez dispensers, and three of the turtles, and what do you know, again, Leonardo is missing. I actually got this bundle from the same place where I got the other three like these little keychains, so I guess the previous owner wasn't really a big fan of Leonardo, because from those keychains and over from here too, Leo is the only one missing. Interesting. It would have been cool to have all four turtles, of course, but Still, I'm pretty happy to have these Bezley sensors because these were never available over here. I only saw them online. Moving on. Here we go. We have the pizza box. Or actually, this is the playset that I was talking about. It's Antonio's Pizzeria pizza set. Or I'm not sure what's the official name of it. I'm not going to open this now, but you will be able to see the pictures on the screen, how it looks opened up. It's in great shape, and it's not really missing anything besides a like a pizza machine that was supposed to fire pizzas. That's the only thing that's missing. Nothing is broken inside, so I was really happy to find this, because if you are not counting the vehicles, I don't have any of only other like playsets from the Turtles, so I was super happy to finally find something that's such in great condition. And last but not least, what I found on the flea market was really surprising to me. I have found brand new, and these were like brand new, still sealed, TMNT trading cards from the 2003 series, and these were made by Konami, so they are like really great quality cards. I bought a starter set and one of these you know, larger sets with a bunch of, I'm not sure, there were 24 packs inside, and you know, it was pretty fun to open them all up. You will be able to see some pictures of the how the cards look. I have already put them in like a binder or like a card collector album. But they are really cool. They also have like foil cards in each, and some of the foil cards are like rare. I actually found two rare ones and two super rare ones, so I was really, or ultra rare ones. I was really happy about that. I'm keeping the boxes because I think they are just unique and cool looking. But yeah, not much to say about that. I didn't get, of course, the full collection, and I ended up with a bunch of doubles. Still, it's something really cool, and I didn't know these existed, honestly. So yeah, it was really a fun find. And yeah, I will stop blabbering now, because that's about it for this flea market haul episode and part 2 of the episode. I wanted to leave the TMNT stuff to this part of the episode, because as you saw, I have a bunch of stuff here. And yeah, again, as I said before in the first part of this video, I am not sure when I will be able to go next to the flea market. We'll see when it will open up back again. I have a suspicion that it will only be next year probably, and who knows when. But when the flea market will come back, I will probably go again and hunt for some more stuff and more toys. Until then, you can hit that subscribe button if you are interested in more toy haul videos that will come soon, hopefully, and you know, other kind of toy and door reviews. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up, and if you want to comment on this video, you will have to go to the link that will appear down below here. That's my Facebook page. You can like it too if you wanted to. I have to turn off, unfortunately, the comments for this video because of the YouTube policy, but you will be able to comment over there on this video. And yeah, tell me what do you think of the haul. And yeah, so that's about it, guys. Until next time, bye.